महावाक्ये जहल्लक्षणायः असंभवः, earlier it was mentioned that जहल्लक्षण and अजहल्लक्षण are not applicable or useful in the case of महावाक्य interpretation तत्त्वमसि, but भागत्याग लक्षण और जहद अजहल लक्षण should be used. The reasoning was not given. Now reasoning is given as to why जहल लक्षण isn't useful in the case of महावाक्या and so too अजहल लक्षण. महावाक्ये जहल लक्षणाय असंभवा सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम वस्तु साक्षी चैतन्यम ब्रह्म चैतन्यम च. The vastu which is revealed by the shastras, entire Vedanta, is Sakshi Chaitanya or Brahma Chaitanya. Individually, you land on the Sakshi, and in the Samashti, you land on the Brahma Chaitanya, which is one and the same. Now, this Chaitanya is on both sides. If you use jahal lakshana means you have to give up the entire meaning. If you give up the entire meaning, then Sakshi Chaitanya on Tompada or Brahma Chaitanya on the other have to be dropped. If you drop Chaitanya, then what remains? Jada. So that is explained here. Tadubhayam Tompada Vachyarthe Tatpada Vachyarthe Cha Pravishtam. Sakshi Chaitanya is there in the Tompada Vachyartha Shakyartha, whereas Brahma Chaitanya is there in Tatpada Vachyartha Shakyartha. Yatra Jahati Lakshana Tatra Samagram Vachyam Parityajya Vachyartha Sambandhi Anyaha Artaha Griyeta. So Vachyartha Sambandhyanya Artaha Griyeta when you use Jahati Lakshana. What is Anyaha from Sakshi Chaitanya or Brahma Chaitanya? You will land on Nama Rupatmaka Prapancha. You will land on Jada or Anatma. Anatma is not being equated to Atma, cannot be equated. Tasmat Mahavakya Jahal Lakshana Svikare Sati. If at all you accept Jahal Lakshana, then what will happen? Vachyartha Dvayantargatam Chaitanyam Vihaya Tad Bahirbhutam Anya Deva Navam Vastu Kinchid Vijneyam Bhavet. Something other than Brahma you have to take as the meaning of the Mahavakya. Chaitanya Danyattu Asat Jadam Dukkha Rupam Cha. What you are trying to give up, that itself will become the meaning of the Mahavakya, which is invalidated. So Asat Jada and Dukkha Rupa you already know. That is not freshly revealed by the Shastra. That is not the end of the search. Tajnyanena na purushartha siddhihi. No purushartha, let alone moksha, but no purushartha is attained by the jnana of asat, jada rupa, dukkha rupa, anatma. Tasmanna mahavakye jahal lakshanayaha sambhava. So usefulness of jahal lakshana in mahavakya, when you have Chaitanya Ausha on both sides and something else also on both sides, there Jahal Lakshana has no meaning. Mahavakye Ajal Lakshanaya Asambhava. Why is it is impossible to land on a useful meaning if you use Ajal Lakshana in Mahavakya? Ajal Lakshana Stale Samagram Vachyartam Aparityajya Tatopyadikam Grihyate. महावाक्ये अजल लक्षणाभ्युपगमे वाच्यार्थ समग्रोपि वाक्यार्थे अन्वितो भवेत्. नाउ शक्यार्थ वाच्यार्थ इज नॉट लीडिंग टू मीनिंग विच मेक्स सेंस. सो यू हैव विरोध इन तत्त्वमसि वेर तत् इज जीवा, त्वम इज ईश्वर. जीवा कैनॉट बी ईश्वर एज इट इज. देयरफॉर देयर इज कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन. इन अजल लक्षण you have to retain the entire meaning and then add an additional meaning. Now if you retain an entire meaning, retain the entire meaning in Jiva Shabda and Ishwara Shabda, the contradiction will still continue. How much ever you add, the contradiction between the original words will still be there. How can you take away contradiction by adding new words. You have to drop which is contradictory, otherwise how much ever you add on any side, the contradiction underlying will still continue. Therefore, the solution is obviously not possible. It is logically impossible to get a solution, a meaningful solution, if you add words while retaining the original contradictory meanings. So Mahavakya Ajal Lakshanabhyupagami Vachyar Samagruopi Vakyarthenvito Bhavet. There will be Anvaya Anuvritti of the earlier words complete. Samagrasya Vachyarthasya Mahavakyarthe Anvayastu Virodhena Sanyutaha. There is already a Virodha. If you continue in the Anvaya by adding new words, you will still have Virodha. Virodha Pariharaya Lakshanashraitavya. The reason you went to Lakshana is because Shakyartha has Virodha. So what is the point in retaining the Virodha, trying to solve the Virodha in the Vachyartha and landing on through Lakshana on a Lakshyartha where the same Virodha continues? Ajal Lakshanashrayane Mahavakya Virodhana Parihrito Bhavati. This Virodha contradiction will continue between Tat and Tvam in Ajal Lakshana. Tasman Mahavakya Ajal Lakshana Kramaha Tyajyo Bhavati. So Ajal Lakshana has no meaning in Mahavakya interpretation. Therefore, what you are left with is Jad Ajal Lakshana or Bhagatyag Lakshana. Mahavakya Bhagatyag Lakshana Angi Karak Kramaha. What is a Krama? We know this. Tatpada Vachya Ishvara, Tvampada Vachya Jiva. We know this. Vyashti Jiva is equated with Samashti Ishvara. Etayuhu Paraspara Viruddhaunsham Vihaya Shuddha Asanga Chaitanyaunsho Lakshanaya Bodhyaha. Through Lakshana, you have to retain the Chetana Amsha on both sides where there cannot be any contradiction because there are no two. There is only one Chaitanya Amsha. The Upadhis are two. Retaining that which is not contradictory or the meaning which is one and the same on both sides, holding on to that and giving up everything else is Bhagatyaga Lakshana. Iyam eva Bhagatyaga Lakshana. Atrayam Siddhantaha. Now, the technicality in this. Who is this Jiva really? Upadhi Sahita is understood. Ishvara is also understood as Samashti Upadhi Sahita. But the definition of Ishvara may generally be agreeable by all the Vyakhyanakaras. However, there are various prakriyas whereby the definition of Jiva changes. So what do you really give up? You hold on to Chaitanya Amsha, what do you really give up? There you have to understand who is this Jiva, a conglomerate of. Therefore, the Abhasavada, Pratibimbavada, these, and also there are other Vadas which may be there which define Jiva differently. These have already been looked into, but now in detail, there is a focus on the definition of Jiva, because without understanding Jiva, how will you land on the Chaitanya Amsha? It is easy to say give up everything and hold on to Chaitanya, but that is not how the study works. When you inquire into it, then what I really am, who I really am, in that inquiry, Chaitanya Amsha cannot be held on to so easily. Because it's your very Swarupa, you cannot hold on to it. So you have to know how to do neti neti, what should you drop. So it is good to know which way you can understand yourself, whichever definition is close or is more convincing to your understanding, you can take that. And then start analyzing those and dropping them, dropping the tadatmya sambandha cognitively. So atrayam siddhanta jiveshwarayo swarupam bahudha advaita granteshu kachyate. In many ways it is described in various advaita granthas. Vivarana granthe ajnana pratibimbo jivaha. Who is jiva as per vivarana grantha vivaranakara? Jiva is pratibimba, where chaitanya pratibimba in ajnana, in the Karana Sharira. That is the definition of Jiva. ईश्वराय तद्बिंब ईश्वराय इत्युच्यते. द बिंब इज ईश्वरा नॉट शुद्ध चैतन्य. ईश्वरा हु इज शुद्ध चैतन्याद अभिन्न. देयर इज नो डिफरेंशिएशन रियली मेड बिटवीन सगुण एंड निर्गुण ब्रह्म. द सगुण ब्रह्म इज द अपीयरेंस ऑफ निर्गुण ब्रह्म हु वी कॉल एज ईश्वरा. दैट ईश्वरा इज द बिंब एंड द रिफ्लेक्शन इन अज्ञान इज प्रतिबिंब. However, Vidyaranya Swami, who also belongs to Vivarna Sampradaya, he refines it further and takes a little deviation and explains it with Sattva Guna Maya for Ishvara as Upadhi and the Abhasa there is Ishvara. Because the Upadhi will have an Abhasa, he varies a little and uses Abhasavada. Abhasavada Vidyarana Swami Mate Shuddha Sattva Guna Pradhana Mayayam Pratifalita Abhasa Ishwaraha. Malina Sattva Guna Pradhana Antakkarana Upadana Bhuta Vidyayam Pratifalita Abhaso Jeevaha Iti Varnyate. So in Abhasavada, the Maya which is Trigunatmika, which itself holds on to primarily Sattva Guna, whereby the Abhasa of Chaitanya there becomes Ishvara, who has nothing to do with Tamas and Rajas Gunas generally. Only when those are useful, he is using them, he is wielding them. But otherwise, he is not influenced by them because of Sattva Guna being primarily there. However, Abhasa, there is a difference between Abhasa and Pratibimba, but they are very close. We will see what are the technical differences later. The Moola Grantha itself will discuss that. Vidyaranya Swami Mate Shuddha Sattva Guna Pradhana Mayam Pratiphalita Abhasa Ishvara. Then who is Jiva? मलिन सत्व गुण प्रधान अंतकरण उपादान भूत अविद्यायां प्रतिफलित आभास जीवः इति वर्ण्यते. हाउएवर दि जीव डेफिनेशन इज आभास वेयर विच इज प्रतिफलित इन अविद्या विच इज मलिन सत्व प्रधान गुण प्रधान. मलिन सत्व इज व्हाट? That sattva which is tainted by rajas and tamas. Thereby jiva has an influence of maya. So is tainted by that avidya which itself is not sattva guna pradhana. Sattva guna is mixed up with rajas and tamas. Thereby मलिन सत्व प्रधान अंतकरण उपादान भूत अविद्या. अंतकरण एक्चुअली इट इज द आभासा. जीवा इज द आभासा इन अविद्या विच इज द उपादान कारण फॉर अंतकरण. देयरफॉर एक्सपांड्स इनटू अंतकरण. कारण शरीर अलोन इज मैनिफेस्ट ओनली इन सुषुप्ति अवस्था. Where we don't have an issue usually because there is no thinking mind there. There is no buddhi which is manifest. Therefore, jiva sleeps. Veiled avarana shakti is completely overpowering where vikshepa has no say at all. In swapna and jagrat avasthas, the buddhi is active, antakkarana is active, vikshepa has a say. Influences the jiva. Avarana is still there, but avarana is not something where one has focus because one has moved away with the avarana. One has moved away into vikshepa, haunted by the vikshepa. So what happens is that although we say antakkarana pratibimba or antakkarana abhasa, we have seen earlier that it is an expanse of avidya. Manifestation of the same pratibimba or abhasa which is an avidya into the antakkarana on waking up of the mind in swapna or jagrata avastha. Thereby there is a difference between the definitions of Ishwara and Jiva across the Abhasavada and Pratibimbavada Prakriyas. Jiveshwara Swarupe Abhasa Pratibimba Avachheda Vadaha. But the definition is not limited only to Abhasa and Pratibimba. There is also Avachheda Vada of Bhamati Kara. What is Abhasavada? Panchadashi Granthe Vidyaranya Swaminaha Antakkarana Abhaso Jiva Ityavochan. So Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya said that Jiva is Antakkarana Abhasa, and we have seen that Antakkarana Abhasa is by manifestation, not only in Antakkarana, but already there is an Abhasa in Avidya which manifests in Antakkarana, because Avidya is the कारण शरीर और उपादान कारण ऑफ अंतकरण ननु अंतकरण आभासो जीव इत्यभ्युपगमे सुषुप्तौ अंतकरण अभावात् जीवाभाव प्रसज्येत. दिस हैज ऑलरेडी बीन आंसर्ड इन द मूल, बट विद्यारण्य स्वामी जी सेज अंतकरण आभास जीव. इफ ही सेज सो इन पंचदशी, देयर इज एन ऑब्जेक्शन टू दैट, बिकॉज इन सुषुप्ति अंतकरण इज नॉट मैनिफेस्ट, इट इज फोल्डेड बैक. In that case, Shushupta Antakkaranasya Abhavat, Jiva Abhavaha, Jivasya Abhava Prasajyeta, Jiva won't be there in Shushupti if you say he is there in the Antakkarana, as an Abhasa in the Antakkarana of Chaitanya. Since in Shushupti Avastha there is no possibility of Antakkarana being manifest, then Jiva can't be there. So this is an objection to which the answer, which is already given, now it is elaborated. Tathasati prajna rupa jiva shushupti abhimani vartate iti prasiddhi virudhyeta iti chenna. There won't be this prajna rupa jiva. If that is the question or objection, it is not so. Antakkarana abhaso jiva iti vadatam vidyaranya swami naam ayam ashayaha. What is the idea when Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya says that jiva is अंतकरणे प्रतिफलितः आभासः चैतन्यस्य आभासः अंतकरणात्मना परिणममान अविद्यांश प्रतिफलित आभासो जीवः. सो अविद्या इज ऑलरेडी देयर. व्हेन यू से अंतकरण, द कारण शरीर इज ऑब्वियसली इंक्लूडेड, बिकॉज अंतकरण इज सूक्ष्म. यू कैन नॉट हैव अंतकरण विच इज अ कार्य विदाउट द कारण अविद्या. So whatever is manifest in Antakkarana is already there in its Karana. We are Satkaryavadis. So there is Yatkinchit Bhava Rupa Avidya, which is the Karana of this Antakkarana, Upadana Karana, and thereby whatever is Pratibhalita as an Abhasa of Chaitanya in Antakkarana is already there in Avidya. Sacha Avidyamsha Shushuptau Api Asti Tasmana Prajna Bhava Prasanga Iti. So Prajna will continue to be there in Shushupti Avastha, meaning Jiva will continue to be as a Prajna in Shushupti, because Avidya has the Pratiphalana of Chaitanya Abhasa. Atrayam Vishesha. What is the difference there though? Jiveshwarona Kevala Abhasa Rupau. So what is the Vishesha there? What is the particular thing to be noticed there is Jiva and Ishwara are not केवल आभास रूप. ऑल्दो द डेफिनेशन सेज आभासा, आभासा ऑफ व्हाट? ओरिजिनल शुड बी देयर फॉर द रिफ्लेक्शन. सो प्रतिबिंब इफ यू से, बिंब इज एज्यूम्ड. इफ यू से आभासा, देयर आभासा इज यू नो सेम्ब्लेंस, रिसेम्ब्लेंस और सेम्ब्लेंस. सेम्ब्लेंस ऑफ व्हाट? So that akanksha will be lingering on. It is there in the garbha of the shabda itself. When you say it is pratibimba, prati, so bimbam bimbam prati, pratibimba. So some kind of dependency or akanksha is there on something else. What is that? That is the original bimba. When you say abhasa also, semblance, abhasa, किम इव लाइक वॉट इट हैज सेम्ब्लेंस रिजेंबल्स वॉट दैट काइंड ऑफ आकांक्षा इज हैंगिंग ऑन इट इज देयर वेरी इनसाइड द वेरी वर्ड दैट यू हैव एज आभास और प्रतिबिंब देयर बाय जीवेश्वरो न केवल आभास रूपो फॉर सिंप्लिसिटी आभास इज द वर्ड यूज देयर बट दे आर नॉट केवल आभास किंतु माया अधिष्ठान चैतन्य माया तत्र चैतन्याभास इत्येतत् त्रयं मिलित्वा ईश्वरः We know this, but then this is important to recall. There is a Maya Adhishthana Chaitanya. Maya Yaha Adhishthana is already there when you say Abhasa. And Maya is there, Adhishthana Chaitanya is also there. Therefore, Abhasa which takes place in Maya, defined as Ishvara, also has Maya and Chaitanya together. So all three, Adhishthana Chaitanya, Maya and Tatra, meaning Tasya Maya ya Chaitanyasya Abhasaha. All these three put together are called as, with one term, as Ishvara. Avidya, Avidyamsha Adhishthana Chaitanyam, Avidyamsha Tatra Chaitanya Abhasaha, Ityetatrayam Militva Jeevaha. Similarly, in the Jiva definition as Antakkarana or Avidya Abhasa, there the other two components, Avidya and Chaitanyamsha, have to be included. Therefore, Avidya Adhishthana Chaitanya, Avidyayaha Yat Adhishthanam Tat Chaitanyam and Avidyamsha, where there is a reflection of Chaitanya, so that Chaitanya, Abhasa, Chaitanya and Avidya, all three put together, is the definition of Jiva. Ishvara upadau shuddha sattva gunasya sattvat Ishvare sarvajnyatva sarvashakti matvadi dharma vartante Jiva upadau malina sattva gunasya sattvat Jive alpashakti matva kinchidnyatvadi dharma vartante The difference between Jiva and Ishvara Vishesha are that Ishvara is sarvajnyatva dharma vishishta, whereas Jiva is alpajnyatvadi dharma vishishta. So why is there such a difference there? Because sattva guna pradhanyam is there in Maya, where Chaitanya reflects in the case of Ishvara. Thereby sarvajnyatva, sarvashaktimatva, all this is possible because there is no influence or restriction by Rajas and Tamas Guna. Whereas in the case of Jiva, Rajas and Tamas interfere with the expanse of Sattva, with the real Shakti of Sattva. Thereby what happens is that Malina Sattva Guna Upadhi does not allow the Jiva to become Sarva Shaktiman Ityadi, Sarvajnyatva Ityadi Gunas cannot be there. Therefore, in Jiva, there is Alpa Shakti, Kinchidnyatva Ityadi Dharmas. Ayam eva Abhasavada Ityuchyate. This is Abhasavada. What is called as Pratibimbavada, Vivaranakara talks about this. Vivaranakara mate Jiveshwarayor Upadhi Ekam eva Ajnanam. So Maya, Ajnana, these are all interchangeable words. However, the difference between Jiva and Ishvara is explained as Jiveshwarayoho Ubhayoho Eka Ajnana Upadhi Katvad Ubhayor Alpajnyatvadi Prasanga Dosho Nasambhavati. So when you are looking at difference between Jiva and Ishvara, Maya or Avidya, interchangeable, if they are the upadis of, it is the upadi for both Ishvara and Jiva, then how is it that Jiva is Alpajna and Ishvara is not Alpajna? Yasmin upadhu pratibimbo jayate tasya upadir ayam swabhavaha. What is the nature of pratibimba? Pratibimbe swadosha upad, swadosha उपधायकत्वं बिंबे तदधना अनाधायकत्वं इति. सो व्हाट इज द नेचर ऑफ द उपाधि. सो इफ यू लुक जीवेश्वर उभयोः एक अज्ञान उपाधिकत्वात्. If the Jiva and Ishvara have one single Upadhi, whether you call it as Maya or Avidya, then this Alpajnatvadi Prasanga Doshaha is possible, is expected to be there because Upadhi is same. Because what I said, in Vivaranakara Mata, Jiveshwara Upadhi Ekam Eva Ajnanam. The same Ajnana called as Avidya, Maya, whatever, is the Upadhi for Jiva also, Ishvara also. Then, Alpajnyatva should be there in Ishvara also. But what is the Upadhi Svabhava? Pratibimbe Svadosho Upadhayakatvam Bimbe Tad Anadhayakatvam Iti. Whatever is there in the Pratibimba, that dosha will not accrue to the Adhaya Bhuta, Adhisthana Bhuta Chaitanya. Or the original will have no flaws of the Pratibimba. This is the nature of the Upadhi. The Upadhi differentiates between the Bimba and Pratibimba. So if you say there is Alpajnyatvadi dosha in both Pratibimbas should be there, we are really talking about Chaitanya, which is the reality. Therefore, whatever dosha is there in the Pratibimba will not accrue to the Bimba. This is the very nature of Upadhi. So the mirror differentiates the original and the reflected. Whatever doshas you are pointing out in the reflected, they will not be there in the original. They will be due to Upadhi. So anyway, Pratibimbe Svadosha Upadhayakatvam Bimbe Tad Anadhayakatvam Iti. Upadehe Pratibimba Paksha Patitvam Iti Niyamo Loke Drishtaha. So whatever, so Upadehe Pratibimba Paksha Patitvam. Whatever is there in the Upadhi, that will start to associate or look as if associated with the Pratibimba. So if the mirror, which is an Upadhi for the Pratibimba, if the mirror has dust or a crack, that will appear to be there in the Pratibimba. Tatra, so what happened? Upadhi Pratibimba Paksha Patitvam Iti Niyamaha Loke Drishta. This is Loka Prasiddha. तथाहि दर्पण रूप उपादो मुख प्रतिबिंबो जायते तत्र ग्रीवास्थम मुखम बिंब इत्युच्यते. व्हाट इज बिंब इन द एग्जांपल ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द फेस इन द मिरर. देयर व्हाटएवर इज देयर ऑन द नेक, ग्रीवा इज नेक, ग्रीवास्थम ऑन द नेक, व्हाट इज देयर रियली देयर आउटसाइड, दैट इज बिंब. वेयर एज तत्र दर्पण रूप उपादिस्थ श्यामत्व पीतत्व लघुत्वादि दोषाः प्रतिबिंबे विभान्ति. बेस्ड ऑन द टाइप ऑफ द मिरर, इफ इट्स अ कलर्ड मिरर, इट्स अ येलोइश मिरर और इट इज अ डार्क मिरर, देन यू विल सी द रिफ्लेक्शन आल्सो बिकम येलो और डार्क रेस्पेक्टिवली. सो दोज आर नॉट देयर इन द प्रतिबिंब. They appear in the Pratibimba, they are really not there in the Bimba. Natu Bimbe Grivastha Mukhe. So, in the Pratibimba also they are not really there, but Vibhanti, there is an Abhasa in the Pratibimba of the colors or the cracks, etc., dust, dirt, whatever is there in the mirror, in the Upadhi, that will appear in the Pratibimba. However, it will not affect the Bimba. एवं दर्पण स्थानीय अज्ञान रूप उपादौ प्रतिबिंब भूत जीवे उपाधि रूप अज्ञान हेतुक किंचिज्ञत्वादि दोषाः वर्तन्ते. सो देयर विल बी दोषास विच अपीयर इन प्रतिबिंब ऑल्दो दे आर नॉट देयर इन द प्रतिबिंब ऑल्सो, वेयर एज इन द ओरिजिनल दे आर डेफिनेटली नॉट देयर, वेदर इट इज किंचिज्ञत्व एज दोष इन द जीव, सर्वज्ञत्व एज अ शक्ति इन ईश्वर. the differentiation is due to the upadhi differences where avidya and maya are same, but the differentiation need not be made. The differentiation is made because of avidya. Jiva is really Ishvara. There is no bheda at all. There is only one jiva who plays the role of Ishvara. When you look at that pratibimba in one way and plays the role of the jiva also under the influence of that, when looked at in another way, neither the sarvajnyatva, sarvashaktimattvam or the jagat kartrutvam ityadi, jagat sthiti, srishti sthiti laya karana, that kind of a thing exists in the Chaitanya really, nor does it exist as bandhakatvam in the jiva. So jiva is not really baddha. He is not different from Ishvara, and Ishvara is not a jagat karana really because of being Shuddha Chaitanya. So the same Ishvara appears to be bound and freed. This is the real Vivarna Siddhanta. Therefore, this Alpajnyatva, Sarvajnyatva, these are only from the perspective that you differentiate. All of these are there in the Avidya. The Sarvajnyatva is also Avidyakrita. Alpajnyatva is also Avidyakrita. Why it appears so in Ishvara and why it appears so in Jiva? There is no reasoning needed there because Avidya or Maya, Maya Sarvasya Sambhavat. Anything is possible. Why should something appear in a particular way? Why should a mango tree come out from a mango seed? Or why should a plant come out of a seed at all? So all these are because such vyavastha is anubhuta. We inquire into the reasoning, but no reasoning is really needed. We have seen this long back in the earlier chapters, where things are explained as this is how it is because it has always been so. Why is it that you don't see much of anything in Swapna which is completely on a tangent to Jagradavastha? Because Jagradavastha Janya Samskara is strong, and that does not allow you to deviate from some simple rules that you know, or some simpler setups that you know. Not that you won't have variation, you may have some variation from those rules also, but usually you see something similar. There may be a mix-up also. There is lot of confusion there. We may doubt, but we don't inquire much during Swapna. Similarly, across Janmas, which are like Swapnas, there is a strong samskara of the earlier Swapna. Thereby, a particular vyavastha is there as to some samskara leads to some phala in such a manner. Thereby, there is a continuous pravaha of impressions after impressions, and they let things continue in a particular manner. There may be some deviation here and there, but we don't inquire into it. We take things for granted. Why should there be any kind of relation and only that kind of relation? So we can say Ishvara Srishti is like that, but then there is no answer beyond that. Even if you say, you know, due to gravity something happens, why that gravity is there, why it is limited only to so much, why does it change when you go across planets, all this is something which cannot be explained. It is so, that's it. You can discover that it is so, but you cannot get really to the bottom of it and say, oh, I know it completely. Nobody can claim so. Thereby, even if the same avidya is the upadhi for jiva as well as Ishvara, some things appear differently in Ishvara, something appears differently in jiva. Whereas the Chaitanya is the same, the jiva is really not different from Ishvara. So it is said that the same entity, ekameva dvitiya brahma, appears as a karana as well as a jiva. So samsarati muchyate cha. सॉरी सो एवं दर्पण स्थानीय अज्ञान रूप उपाधौ प्रतिबिंब भूत जीवे उपाधि रूप अज्ञान हेतुक किंचिज्ञत्वादि दोषाः वर्तन्ते. देयर इज अ टिप्पण ऑन जीवेश्वर जीवाणीश्वर नॉट बीइंग केवल चिदाभास. स्वतादात्म्य संबंधवशात् अधिष्ठान अनतिरिक्ततया यद्भाति तद् आरोपितम् इत्युच्यते. व्हाट इज आरोपित अध्यस्त स्वतादात्म्य संबंधवशात् ड्यू टू द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द तादात्म्य संबंध ऑफ वनसेल्फ विद समथिंग विच यू आर नॉट. सो ऑफ वनसेल्फ विद विच one is not, there is an identification. Due to that identification, adhisthana anatirikta taya yad bhati, what appears as different from the real you. So this deha is me. Or in the case of someone else also or something else, this is sarpa. Adhisthana anatirikta taya, because adhisthana idamausha is there. Without knowing the vishesha of the adhisthana, what is known is the adhyastha. Therefore, what appears to be non-different from the underlying yad bhati tad aropitam ityuchyate. So what appears as non-separate from what really is underlying with tadatmya sambandha, that is called as aropita. Aropitam cha adhisthana atiriktataya. Sorry. Aropitam cha adhisthana atiriktataya na bhati. So aropita cannot have a pratiti without the adhisthana. Yatha rajjau aropita sarpa rajjva atiriktataya na bhati. Kintu rajjva anatiriktataya rajjva swarupam achhadya sarpo bhati. So what happens in the case of Rajju Sarpa? Rajju itself appears as Sarpa. Sarpa cannot have an appearance without Rajju. So Sarpa veils the Rajju and then Rajju itself appears as Sarpa. Tatha Maya Avidya. So Maya Vidyastha Abhasa Vapi Aropitatvena Hetuna Tayor Adhisthana Bhuta Kutastha Brahma Chaitanyatiriktataya Na Bhatum Arhataha. Therefore, when it is said Jiva and Ishvara are not Kevala Chidabhasa, it means that there has to be Adhisthana Chaitanya, where there is Tadatmya Sambandha with the Upadhis of Jiva and Ishvara, and thereby when you say Chidabhasa in the Jiva Upadhi or Ishvara Upadhi as Jiva and Ishvara, there you have to take the Adhisthana Chaitanya as well as the Upadhi. Only Chidabhasa is not valid, therefore the triad has to be accepted. Kintu tau ubhau api abhasau swadhisthana bhuta kutastha brahma chaitanyabhyam tadatmya sambandha rupaikatvam prapya adhisthana bhuta kutastha brahmano swarupam achhadyeva vibhataha. So in both cases, Jiva and Chaitanya, in the case of Jiva, Sakshi Chaitanya is veiled. Avidya continues to have the reflection or abhas of Chaitanya and then appears as Jiva. Similarly, in the case of Ishvara, Tasmad Adhisthana Chaitanya Maya Vidya Rupopadi Sahita Chidabhasascha Jivova Ishvarova Bhavati. So when abhasa is mentioned, you have to understand that Chaitanya, which is the Adhisthana, and where there is a reflection, that Upadhi also has to be included in the case of Jiva and Ishvara. So anyway, that's an elaboration for completion I covered. Going back to Pratibimba Vada, where Jiva Pratibimba has a pratiti of these Alpajnyatvadi doshas, but they are not really there in the Bimba Rupa Ishvare Natte Dosha Santi. Now, in Vivarnavada, what has been explained? It started with विवरणकारमते जीवेश्वरयोः उपाधिः एकमेव अज्ञानम्। However, why is it that the jiva has alpajnyatva and Ishvara does not have alpajnyatva but has sarvajnyatva? What is said is that sarvajnya Ishvara. We have to recollect what has gone by earlier. There was an introductory statement there as to in the end there was a siddhanta mentioned. What was said there? विवरणमत विवरण ग्रंथे अज्ञान प्रतिबिंबः जीवः तद्बिंबः ईश्वरः इति उच्यते। सो इफ यू लुक एट द टेक्निकलिटी, जनरली वी से दैट माया प्रतिबिंबित ईश्वर, अविद्या प्रतिबिंबित जीव, वी गेट बाय। हाउएवर इफ यू वांट टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन आभासवाद एंड प्रतिबिंबवाद, बिटवीन विवरण प्रतिबिंबवाद एंड आभासवाद, वेर शुद्ध चैतन्य is considered as bimba, so whereas shuddha chaitanya is considered as jiva and abhasavada, the ishvara here who is shuddha chaitanya abhinna, really there is not much discussion or differentiation made between ishvara and brahma. Vivarnakara says ishvara is tatpada vachyartha, lakshyartha is shuddha chaitanya brahma, nirguna brahma. But we don't need to discuss that. All these objections which are raised by Purva Pakshis, for to answer them, we have talked about Maya, etc. But the same Maya is Avidya also. True to the Ekajiva Vada, which is the Tatpare of the Shruti, where multiple Jivas are as much Bhranti as Jiva is a Bhranti. Why do you need Gaurava, where you can do away with this samsarittvam, samsara, all these are due to bhranti. It is all mithya. Why do you waste time in analyzing many jivas, this prapancha, how one gets mukti, how other remains baddha, all this discussion is not necessary. If your goal is moksha, then you would do better by taking to a shortcut method, which is knowing that there is one Ishvara, basically ekameva advitiya brahma, whether you call as brahma or atma, it is one single Sachidananda vastu, who as Ishvara becomes jagat karana, a role to play, or we call him as जगत कारण ईश्वरा, हु इज नॉट रियली जगत कारण ईश्वर। वाई? बिकॉज देर इज नो जगत, देर इज नो रियल जगत एट ऑल, देर इज नो रियल जीवा एट ऑल, देर इज नो रियल ईश्वरा नीडेड, बिकॉज देर इज नो रियल जीवा हु हैज टू बी गिवन कर्म फला, बिकॉज ही हैज नॉट रियली इंडल्ज इन अ रियल जगत क्रिएटेड बाय रियल ईश्वरा। सो इफ देर इज नो रियल बद्ध जीवा, because there is only shuddha chaitanya ekameva advitiya brahma, all this discussion, elaboration and debates are not really useful. Therefore what is done is that this shuddha brahma, who need not be talked about because we are in vyavahara, where shuddha chaitanya does not remain shuddha at all, meaning if you are in vyavahara, you are already in a dream. So in the dream, all this discussion of the waking world is not really useful at all, because you are stuck in a dream, which is a bhranti. In reality, the atma itself goes through swapna, jagrat and sushupti avastha without really going through it. Why? Because it is asanga. Now when you inquire into it as a dreamer, then what will you say? This who is this dreamer? The waker is the dreamer. Will you say that the jiva, who is anyway unknown in waking also, is continuing as swapna jiva? You wouldn't. So as a dreamer, you will say the dreamer is the waker, non different from waker. There is no discussion of shuddha chaitanya atma there. although the same atma has the upadhi of jagrat avastha of swapna avastha and sushupti avastha, the discussion is from the perspective of the dreamer, and in that discussion, who is the dreamer? He is the same waker who slept and woke up in a dream. A similar thing is used here where you say Shuddha Chaitanya discussion is not needed because Shuddha Chaitanya is the real entity who has no business in becoming a karma phala data for Jiva, who has done karma in Jagat, whereby there is a karta needed for Jagat. Such a thing is not there at all. Expectancy isn't there. Therefore, Shuddha Chaitanya is not talked about, and thereby Ishwara, who is not different from Shuddha Chaitanya, Jiva, who is not different from Shuddha Chaitanya, they are discussed. And in that discussion, Ishwara is the Bimba who has Pratibimba in Avidya, also called as Maya, and becomes a Jiva as though. So the as though Ishwara is reflected, or as though reflected in Maya or Avidya, and becomes as though Jiva. So this is the core of Pratibimbavada. Thereby, now if you see Ajnana Pratibimba is Jiva, Tadbimba means Ajnana Pratibimba needs a Bimba, that Bimba is Ishwara. Therefore, you don't need two Upadhis, there is only one Upadhi. And now the question as to why Ajnana being the Upadhi for Ishwara also and Jiva also. Jiva becomes Alpajna, but Ishwara does not become Alpajna, because Ishwara is Sarvajna, who is reflected in as Bimba into the Avidya or Maya Upadhi, and Upadhi makes this Jiva lose his Sarvajnyatvam and become Alpajna. Appearance. So there is a pratiti of Alpajnyatvam in Jiva, which is not his real nature at all. His real nature is being free. Sarvajnyatva. Sarvajnyatva, for lack of a better word, there is nothing to know, because Nyadhatu accepts a karma. It is a sakarmaka dhatu. So Sarvajnyatva is figurative there, because it is there in the Bimba Sarvajnyatva. Why? With the expectancy of Jiva and the Jagat being there, Sarvajnyatva, Sarvakaranatva is all attributed, it is inferred in Ishwara. From that perspective, you say Ishwara the Bimba is Sarvajna. Jiva, who is reflection of Ishwara, somehow due to Upadhi influence, loses these Sarvajnyatva, the attributes, dharmas, and becomes Alpajnyatva, appears to be Alpajna. And now you see why Ishwara is not going to be Alpajna, because he is not a reflection at all. He is the original Bimba. And that is answered here in this question which was raised as Pratibimbavada, their Vivarna Karamate, Jiveshwari Upadhi, Ekameva Jnanam. To this, if there is an objection, Jiveshwarayohu Ubhayo Eka Ajnana Upadhi Katwad, Ubhayor Alpajnyatwadi Prasanga Dosha Na Sambhavati. So you should add even then. So you should say Tathapi. So you can say Tathapi, meaning Jiveshwari Ubhayohu Eka Ajnana Upadhi Katwadapi, Ubhayoho Alpajnyatvadi Prasanga Doshaha Na Sambhavati. Tathapi should be read here to understand why, because this is not an explanatory statement at all. In fact, this raises a doubt as to why is such kind of a dosha not there in Ishwara Alpajnyatvadi, whereas it is there in Jiva, if the Upadhi is same. However, what is being said? What was said much earlier, you have to bring that here and say, why so? So the hetu is that yataha jivaha pratibimbo bhavati isharascha bimbaha bhavati tatha. So that is the reason. So tathapi is answered by that answer tathapi is because of the justification which has gone by earlier, and the explanation is given here as to pratibimbe swadosha upadhayakattvam bimbe tad anadhayakattvam iti. Ishvara is bimba, therefore the flaws of the upadhi do not accrue to the bimba Ishvara, such as alpajnyatva. However, the flaws of the upadhi appear to be there in the pratibimbita jiva. So evam darpanasthaniya ajnana rupa upado pratibimba bhuta jive upadhi rupa ajnana hetuka kinchijnyatvadi dosha vartante bimba rupa ishvare na te dosha santi. However, in the Ishvara who is bimba rupa, there are no such dosha. Ata eva ishvare sarvajnyatvadaya santi jive cha kinchijnyatvadaya. This is the difference by which you understand why alpajnyatva, alpashaktimatva ityadi doshas are not there in Ishvara, but they are in jiva. There is a tippana here. प्रतिबिंबवादे शुद्धं ब्रह्म ईश्वरः एव ईश्वरः. नाउ यू हैव टू नो शुद्ध ब्रह्म इज नॉट डिस्कस सेपरेटली. निर्गुण ब्रह्म वाय ही हिमसेल्फ इज ईश्वर. देयर इज नो डिफरेंस. देयर आर नो टू ब्रह्मास. देयरफॉर द सेम निर्गुण ब्रह्म अपीयर्स टू बी सगुण एंड सगुणत्वम इज नॉट रियल. इट इज मिथ्या. देयर इज नो डिफरेंस एट ऑल. देयरफॉर इन प्रतिबिंबवाद शुद्ध ब्रह्म इज ईश्वर. तस्मिन् सर्वज्ञत्वादि धर्माः अपि स्वतः न सम्भवन्ति. देन हाउ कैन यू हैव सगुणत्वम इन दैट ब्रह्म सर्वज्ञत्व. दैट इज नॉट देयर एट ऑल. स्वतः न सम्भवन्ति. दे आर नॉट देयर एट ऑल बिकॉज शुद्ध चैतन्य शुद्ध ब्रह्म इज निर्गुण ब्रह्म. यू कैन नॉट हैव सर्वज्ञत्व. यू कैन हैव चैतन्य विच इज नॉट अ धर्म एट ऑल. चैतन्य इज द वेरी स्वरूप. सच्चिदानंद इज द वेरी स्वरूप ऑफ निर्गुण ब्रह्म. वेरा सर्वज्ञत्व सर्वशक्तिमत्व दीज आर ऑल गुणास विच आर नॉट देयर बाय देमसेल्व्स. सो स्वतः न संभवन्ति. तथापि जीवाश्रित किंचिज्ञत्वादिकम् अपेक्ष्य शुद्धे ब्रह्मणि बिंबत्व ईश्वरत्व सर्वज्ञत्वादि धर्माः आरोपिताः. फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द जीवा हु इज अल्पज्ञ to contrast with the pratibimba jiva, you have to see sarvajnyatva in Ishvara. So they are inferred through aropa. They are not really there. If you say jiva is alpajna, has very less shakti also, alpa shaktiman, then why is it so that I am limited? This is the question. I want to be free from what? From limitations, from alpajnyatva. It is not that I want to become sarvajnya. If someone tells you, you will have sarvajnyatvam, but you will become dukhi. But the reasoning that we have is that I have all sorts of limitations. I would like to be free from all sorts of limitations. So what is that? It has to be in contrast as an antonym to alpajnyatvam. Alpashaktimatvam. So you infer that the flip side, the freedom is sarvajnyatvam. The freedom is sarvashaktimatvam. They are not real. What kind of shakti will you have? Because shakti has to be something else. If you say sarvashakti, I need all sorts of shaktis, you are wanting a second. Whereas there is ekam eva advitiya brahma. That ekameva dvitiya brahma cannot have sarvajnyatva also. So thinking of going beyond limits, trying to free yourself from limitations of all types, you see the limitlessness which cannot be thought about in such a manner that you talk about all sorts of powers. So you say, I have limited thinking, I would like to have all sorts of thinking possible. If you say, I have less dhana, you don't say you want infinite dhana. Nobody can think of infinite dhana. So when you think of wanting to be rich, you want to have all the wealth. So all sorts of wealth possible I would like to have. This is the dhana ichcha. Meaning what? It's an explanation as to what would I like to have. I wouldn't like to be in poverty. So I don't want to have alpa dhana. So I want sarva dhana. So instead of alpa dhana, you think of sarva dhana. You cannot think purnatvam as an infinity, although that is the real nature. Therefore, the bimba, Ishvara, is thought as sarvajna ityadi, because there is nothing called as sarvajnatvam, which is there in Brahma, who is nirguna, who is really you. So look at the beauty of pratibimba vada. Shuddha Brahma is called as Ishvara. तस्मिन् सर्वज्ञाति सर्वज्ञत्वादि धर्मापि स्वतः न संभवन्ति तथापि जीवाश्रित किञ्चिज्ञत्वादि कम अपेक्ष्य. कंसीडरिंग दैट आई एम लिमिटेड एज जीवा शुद्धे ब्रह्मणि बिंबत्वेश्वरत्व सर्वज्ञत्वादि धर्मः आरोपितः. सो व्हेन यू से देयर इज सर्वज्ञत्वम ऑन द अदर साइड बिंब, दैट बिंबत्वम इज टू बी आरोपित फर्स्ट. सो यू से Brahma is the Shuddha Chaitanya, is the Bimba. But then, Bimbatvam is Aropita. If you have Aropa of Bimbatva, then Ishwaratva is also Aropita there. So the creator who created this world and me in that, this is the thinking of the Jiva. Thereby, you see Ishwaratvam also in that entity. So I don't know this mind-boggling entity, whoever it is. So Yadrishopi Asi Tadrishaya Shivaya Namaha, says one kavi there. I don't know who you are, however you are, to that kind of Shiva is my namaskara, says the kavi there. So that is the thinking of the Jiva. Jiva says this Bimba has to be there, since Shastra says that I am the Pratibimba. So if I am Pratibimba, and when you say Pratibimba, obviously Shuddha Chaitanya and the Upadhi Amshas are also there. So as a Pratibimba, there has to be Bimba. That Bimbatva is Aropita on one who is without a second, Nirguna Brahma, Brahmatma. Then Ishwaratva is also Aropita. Once Ishwaratva comes in, because I am Alpa Shaktiman, Alpatva, Alpa Jnya Jiva, who I pray to, who I approach, who I am an Ausha of, has to be Sarvajna, Sarvashaktiman. Therefore, to contrast, it is inferred and it is Aropita in Shuddha Brahma. Vastutastu Jiveshwarau Ubhav Api Shuddha Brahma Swarupau Eva. Once you understand this setup, that there is nothing called as Sarvajnyatva really, which I am searching, because I am not Alpajna at all. The freedom from Alpajnyatvam is also freedom from Sarvajnyatvam. The freedom from Alpashaktimatvam is also the freedom from Sarvashaktimatvam. I am Shuddha Chaitanya. Satchidananda Brahma, who has no gunas at all. Tatra na kopi dharma sambhavati. There cannot be any dharma in me. So all that I seek of may sound like siddhi, but these siddhis are of no use to me. They will also bind me. I want to be free from both pairs, whether they are Ishvara dharmas or Jiva dharmas. These dharmas are imagined. What I really am, I am the Bimba Gata Pratibimbagata Shuddha Chaitanya. So that was the Tippana there. Then Abhasa Pratibimba Vadayor Bhedaha. This is going to get a little more technical now. And hair splitting is done as to what is the difference between Abhasa and Pratibimba Vada. We have seen this in the Tippana in the earlier chapters. And there were some follow-on questions also. I tried to explain them in one and an off class. Summing up, but still details are, you know, they are sought after by many. Many have this question. if we understand well and good, if we don't understand also well and good, don't hold on to this. For completion, we'll go through this, and this is the reason that the sadhu has covered it also, because it's vichara sagara. It cannot be missing anything. So although the tippana has covered it, the mula also covers it in a particular manner. We'll see what are these hair splitting differences between pratibimba and abhasavada, although really they don't have much bearing on moksha per se, on pursuit also. But what happens is that we are, you know, logically thinking people, or we consider ourselves so. So we'll have all these questions which will come, and once they come up, they may be obstacles to our landing on the tattva. Therefore, to take away these obstacles, the details are given. Sukha nityam saprakasham vyapakam namarupaya adhishthanam buddhye bodhyam buddher drukyattu nirna param sarva vedanta vidyam pratyak param mahaha tadeva annamattvanya diti me nishchita matihi. Om Tat Sat. Any questions? Okay, namaste.